Okay, this is a bridal gele style. It's not for normal, that is not for just someone going to attend occasion. This is for bride. So usually when I want to make this style, I make use of two different colors. And today, I will be making use of red and white. I chose these two colors because it will be very obvious when you combine them together. So that you can also get what I'm doing clearly. So the first thing I did was to cut four pieces of the red because I intend covering the back with the red. So I cut out four pieces. I'm going to be using two of the pieces to form a pleat for the red. And then I will also cut out two pieces of the white to also form pleat for the white. And the length of the gele or the ashoke I'm using to form this pleat is 20 inches by 12. You know that each of the ashoke measures 6 inches. So what I'm using is 20 inches, that is the length, and then the width, which is the wideness, is 12. So I cut out for both the white and then the red. So I have pleated the red part. That's the part you see me putting aside. Then I'm cutting out the white, the same two pieces, which we, and then the length is the same 20. Now the reason I'm cutting 20 20, you know, usually I work with 20 as my normal base, but because I'm going to cross it, I cut 20 20, and that's not the only reason I cut 20. The other reason is that I'm not going to be attaching separate belts to hold the back. So, which means each of these gele you see now, each of the pleats will be having space for the belt on it. And to cover the back, I already explained that I cut out four pieces of red. Every one I cut out is the same 20. Usually when I'm covering my gele, I cover with 20 inches. So I'm not going to change from that 20 inches because I have a longer length. No, 20 inches will be for the cover of the back. On both sides, I will have extra part of it, which I can use to attach my hook and loop. So when I attach the hook and loop, I'll be attaching it directly on the base. I will not be having extra parts for the belt. No, the hook and loop will be attached directly on the base. I think I've sent in up to 3 videos on base, and by now I want to trust that you can do your base well, and you can also okay. Now one very important thing is that by the time you finish crossing your you always have this extra part. Do not allow this part to bother you. Do not trim it out, because when you trim it out, it can start losing. Do not trim it out at all. Just leave it like that. By the time you fix your gele on top of it, it can be, you can use it that way, you understand? It's not going to pose any challenge at all. So please don't cut it out. Just make sure that while crossing it, you don't really have excess. There's another pattern of crossing that I use 15-15 for. When I do that, it means I'm going to attach extra handle. Okay, quickly, you can see where I'm placing the hook and loop now, and you can see that there is distance. The reason for it is so that the space I'm giving underneath now, I can use it to fix the gele itself, you understand? And this belt will not act as any, it will not disturb anything at all. So that's why you see that I'm placing it upwards. And the one you see that I'm placing there is the part that is not smooth. Remember I said that the smooth part should always face down. So this is just it. I am done with the base. I'll be continuing with it with the rear part later. Have a nice day. Okay, I'm going to start straight away with the second part, and quickly, because I'm going to be doing my design with the white, I'm not using the white to tie but just to design it. So I'm cutting out the part of the white that I'll be using, and this length I am using is between 30 to 36, That's what I'm using, between 30 to 36. The reason I used that length is so that by the time I fold it together, it will be able to spread far, because your length determines how far your fan can spread. You understand? If I want it to spread more than what I am doing now, I can use up to 45. But I think for the project at hand, 36 is okay. 35, 36 is very okay. So, of course, we know that Ashoke itself is just 6 inches. And then the part that I'll be fixing at the back, I made two of these very lengths. So I attach it together. And then the part I'm using for the fan now, the part I'm tying now, because I'm going to tie half fan, is 45 inches by length, and then 18 by width. That is, the wideness is 18, the length is 45. I actually used 45 to be on the safer side, you understand? You can work with anything from 35, we do half fan for you. 35, we do half fan. But because of the method I usually use, I normally like want to play with my materials and have more than enough. You understand? So, as you can see now, just the same way I did the half fan before that I've sent to you is what I'm doing. And very, very unfortunately, the part I'm going to place this fan now is not my right hand. Usually, my right hand is on the other side. So, I usually find it very difficult when I'm doing pleat with my the hand that is not too favorable to me. I need to be very careful. But the reason I'm placing the pleat on this particular side now is because that is the side where I have the white. You understand? I don't want to place red on red and white on white. If I do that, well, it might be fine, but I don't like it that way. I usually, after mixing my base, I also like to like mix the top. I place red on white or whichever color I'm using, you understand? So that the base will look, that's where the beauty is in as far as I'm concerned. So that's why I'm actually placing my fan on the white part, though it's not my right hand, but I just have to work with it. So now, the part where I have pleated to now, this is what I usually do for me to get my full fan. I'm just going to tag that part now. I'm going to use my needle and thread and then tag that part. Well, after I secure that part together now, I will lose the ending, that is the ear or the neck side that I tag, you know, I tag it down while I was doing the first pleat. I will lose it and then I will move this very part where you see me tacking now back to the neck. You understand? So that will enable the pleat to start flowing from that part. If you leave it like this now, it's not like it will not be okay, but how do I explain it? The neck part will look like it's not high enough. The fan is not really flowing to that part. It will look as if your fan is starting from the midpoint. I don't know. It will not be even. So what I do usually, as you see me lose that place now, I will move it back. So you can see the reason why I'm using enough material, you understand? I use 45 because now when you move, all that part I'm moving backward, they are part that I will surely like cut off. But what I'm trying to achieve here is that I'm trying to achieve this flow starting from the ear. You understand? Starting from the very neck side, I want to achieve that flow. So if you look at it now, you see that, yes, that flow is really resting on the neck. So this is how I target it, and this is how I get it. Then I'll just continue my pleat. Now let me ship in something. If you are tying and you are not doing auto gele, and you really want your pleat to flow, what I do is this. After placing my base, you know, it's not like this one that we cut the pieces off, you understand? So after placing my base, I will start the pleat. When I start the pleat to an extent, I will lose the base again, ask somebody to help me hold that pleat part, and then I will move the base to the side again. So when I move it, it will help me to move the pleats that I've been doing, and then the pleat will start at the, from the neck. You know, I don't really do tutorials on how to tie. I just do auto gele. Maybe sometime I might really ship in how to tie, because they are getting a good auto gele. I'm sorry. Oh man, I'm stressed. Getting a good auto gele has to do with your ability to tie properly. So if you are doing auto gele and you know that you cannot tie properly, I will advise that you start practicing how to tie. It's very important, because it is from your tying properly that your auto gele will be well defined. You understand me? So this is it. I'm just continuing until I'll get to the very, very end of it. Then, if possible, I will still move the fan again. Now, you can see that when I pleat and pleat, maybe 1, 2, 3, when I get to a certain stage, I will use my thread and needle, and then I will tack it. The reason I'm doing this is because if you don't do this and you carry this gele out, in short, it will just scatter. But with what I am doing now, I can drop this top of gele and not fix it today, not even fix it tomorrow, not fix it next tomorrow. I'll just drop it there. When I'm ready to fix it, I'll just carry and fix it on the base. Sometimes when I have a lot of work at hand, the first thing I normally do is to prepare the top. So when I prepare the top and I tack it down like this, I just pack them on top of each other, on top of each other, and leave it like that. When I'm ready with all my base and I've prepared all the top, I know that the only thing I need to do is sit down and start to fix it on the base. So it is very necessary that you work along with the thread. And if you wash carefully, you see that my thread, I always leave it underneath. It is always under what I am preparing now, so that when I pleat and pleat and pleat, I need to move a little distance to tack it down. I'll just, from the bottom of the tie I'm preparing now, move to that distance, bust it out, take it back in, out, and take it back in, and make sure that it's well secured. So every part of this gele you are seeing now is well secured with my needle and thread. And because that is the final part now, I'm going to use my needle and thread to really hold it properly. So, and that's what I'm going to do right now. Sometimes, because that part is very thick, it used to be hard. And whenever I have that very thick part that is difficult for me to come out, for the needle to come out, what I do is just push. And when I get the mouth of the needle out, I use my plier. I have plier to pull it out. I'll just use my plier and pull it out. I have plier so that I will not start piercing myself. So I work with plier. Though I did not do that here, but I'm just telling you. So when you find something difficult, don't use your teeth. Because when you try to do that, just think of the possibility of the needle just piercing your throat. Ha! Shineke, God will not agree. So please, if you don't have plier, it's part of your requirement. For you to get plier, especially when we are, I'm going to make a video on how I make auto gele with that ordinary tie that they call it sego or whatever. I don't really know the name of, but it's not ashoke, that one that is silky and very strong. I will make a video on how to use it. When I'm doing that work, I work with plier continuously because it's not as soft as ashoke. So now you can see, after securing the ending part with my needle and thread properly, the next thing I did was to just twist this part down. There is no need cutting the part out. You understand me? There's no need. Actually, when I work with ashoke, I don't easily cut, except for the part that I'm going to fix the handle. If not, I don't cut because I just take my size and work with the size. I know that I don't really need to start cutting and cutting and cutting again and again. So that, because ashoke used to lose too much, so I don't really cut. All right. So let's go to how to prepare the attachment, which is the design part. I have a smaller one and then I have a bigger one. The smaller one I am using is about 18 inches. And then you can just see the way I'm folding, like I'm doing pleated skirts. You understand? When you turn it to the back, you iron, turn it backward, you iron again. I prefer using iron because it brings out the pleats better than when you just use your ordinary hand to do it. If you use iron for it, your pleat will really, really be well defined. You will love your work. But sometimes when we do it with our hands, though, we do with our hands, use a table edge to smoothen and smoothen very tight, and then your pleat might come out too. But I prefer using iron. If you have iron, please do use your iron. So the next thing I'll do is just secure the edge with needle and thread to make sure that it is well held together. I just make sure that it's well secured. And then after securing it, I will open it for you to see. Like I said before, I said I prepared two parts. This is a small part and this is measuring 18 inch by 6. And then the second part is measuring at 36 inches by 12, because I joined it because I needed height in that one. So that's the one you are seeing is high. So the width of this one is 12, yes, and then the length is 35 because I need it to open very well. I use the same process I used for the smaller one. So let's go back to the gele. Now this long one, I'm just going to place it at the back of the red. I'll just lay it down like I'm resting it to sleep, use my needle and thread, and then secure it to the base of the gele. After which, I'll just spread it open like this now, and then I'll use my pin to hold it. That's the reason I was saying, if you need it to spread further, you can use between 45. But what I have here is 36. You understand? So if you want it like, I like it to spread, sometimes when I do it, I will spread it out from the back to the very part where you see me twist. You understand? But in that case, I don't need to use the small one. I will not use the small one. So this white will just flow from the back of that thing out to the twisted part. But this is not what I'm doing. So that's the reason I have used 36. And then I'll be attaching the smaller one so you can see how beautiful it has transformed the gele suddenly. You understand me? So like I said, this is a brighter gele idea. It's not for, now somebody just going to attend an occasion. It's not for such person. It's for the owner of the gbedu, the owner of the owambe. You understand, it can be birthday or whatsoever, but it's for the real celebrant. So it can be marriage, it can be birthday, it can be anniversary. It is for the celebrant, you understand. So most times when I do work for celebrant, I like to do something I know nobody will wear to that place, you understand. No person in his normal sense will go and carry this type of a tie and go and attend another person's occasion that is not our own. You understand me? So I always want to come up with some great ideas that can differentiate the bride or differentiate the celebrant from those that are attending the party. And I do hope you enjoy this tutorials now. So you can see the short one doing his job at the front and adding beauty to the very, very front there. So finally, the part where I rest the short one now, I'll quickly use a stick rose. You know, there's this rose they call stick rose. I like stick roses because of the flexibility of the rose. It's very flexible. The edge, the iron, or what should I say, the wire at the end is very, very flexible. Even without attaching your hot glue to this these roses, you can just use the wire that is in the roses to like tie it to the gele and it will just stay. Perfectly. All you need might just be a little needle and thread to tack it. So I do hope you love today's tutorial. Is for me it is beautiful. There's something else I wanted to do, but because I don't want it to get too busy, but let me just say to you, you can stone the white. You understand? You can use your pears on the white part, the white that is spreading at the back there. Just attach your red pears all over it round. It will give it another beauty. You can also attach, glue your white pears all over the red. It will give it another transformation. Or we can use gold. It's whatever you like, you know. It's all about creativity. Thank you so much. I love you. And I will see you in my next video. Yeah, I do hope you love this one. So I'll be seeing you in my next video. And quickly, if you are yet to subscribe to my channel, please, 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 please do so. It's just a way of telling YouTube that you love what I'm doing. You are not paying anything for it. Is that okay? So thank you so much. Bye for now.